Wait, so yo, peep this, yo, check me out, yo, I see you. So I saw the title. First of all, how y'all doing? Good. That's what's up. Look, so I saw this video where I was like, yo, I'm gonna react to this Jack Harlow funniest slash most sus moments. So I was like, I gotta give y'all content that's not just TikTok. And I saw this and I'm like, yes. And then y'all see that? Y'all see, like, I don't know how to, like, focus that shit. Y'all see that? You see that? Like, do you... Lil Nas, basically. Like, did, like, watch. I don't go to school. Okay, what you do? I'm a dancer. Quick question. So, you know, like, it's the, that challenge type shit. Like, viral. So, I just thought that was crazy. How, like, literally... As soon as I pulled this shit up, and like a little, like, I don't know, that shit just popped up on my phone. It's just meant to be. I don't know. Yo, Jack. I mean, I think in like the bio or whatever, in like the, what the fuck, the description, what is it in the, I don't know, the caption. Yeah, it's like he was gonna block me for this shit, and I'm just saying.
And these are my ABCs.
I don't know, I'm not gonna assume you played for that team, but I know he played for that team. So Jack, I'm just, you know what I'm saying?
A, anus. F, fuck. P, wait, pussy. What? Had to do it. Z, Zaddy. It's like, Zaddy's like, when I like run into one of my homeboys, I'm like, what's up, Zaddy? Like, it's just like, Zaddy, you know what I'm saying? One of my like homeboys, though. None of that, just like, he's a Zaddy. Like, he looks like a Zaddy. Like when he's shirtless.
What is up with the fouling? Why would you say you're fouling so much out here?
Oh, I saw this shit.
You are so fine, bro.
Other than that, I'd like to ask about the game, man. You're really persistent. You're a great guy. What are you looking at, man? You're a great guy, man. You're out here, you're working hard, your team's working hard. What do you have to say about that?
Sorry, I get so nervous when I talk to you, bro. My fault. It's like, far from over. It's a close game.
Bro, look at the dude, you know, next to him. Like,
that's the type of game we like. We're physical players. I just wish you were playing, dog, so I could guard you.
I think we're going to go ahead and kick it to somebody else now. I don't know what you... What the hell type of interview was that, man?
What do you do, like, on days off? I know people say no days off, no sleep, but what do you do, like, on a day off? You go to basketball games, Kentucky Derby?
I like to party. I like to get faded. I like to kick it with women. I like to kick it with men. Like, I do a lot of stuff. I be chilling.
Yeah.
Yeah. I try to enjoy myself.
You like to kick it with men too here in our studio too, man.
Hell yeah, there's plenty of men in here.
Yeah, yep. Not like that though, but we can.
You know, it's the sausage party. I don't know what's happening. Why somebody snickering?
It just sounded funny when he said it.
Get some more men in here right now.
Hey, boys.
I love a tall rapper.
Wait, what do you say?
I like a tall rapper.
I love a tall rapper.
How tall are you?
6'3".
Nice. Yeah. There you go.
You gotta love it.
I knew I liked
you.
Stand up.
I just walked through the gayest part of Atlanta, and I think I caught a glimpse of what it feels like to be a woman. Oh my God. I was getting shot at. Now it felt good, low key, but I also felt violated. And listen, I know how I'm rocking, I got no issue, but wow.
Wow. So he said, I like that walk. White boy, and my whole walk changed after that.
Next guest is a multi-platinum selling rapper you know from his smash hit What's Poppin'. We're so excited to welcome him here to the Late Late Show, the always cool, the supremely talented Jack Harlow.
Hey. He's here. No judgment. No judgment though. Oh, he's gonna.
Jack, how you doing?
He's gonna.
Good?
Fuck.
What's up, Big Daddy? I'm happy to be here.
Oh, I love you calling me Big Daddy. What can I call? What can I call you? Little
Big Daddy.
Oh, we're both Big Daddy.
Yeah, we're Big Daddy to each other.
We're just two Big Daddies.
You get it?
Why not? I love it.
I love it.
What's up, y'all? I'm Jack Harlow, and I'm here to play a game of song association with L. Money. If it ain't about the money, don't be hitting me up. I don't want to get nervous.
Tell me, man, if we can, we know we're not giving out change and shit. Just right now, all we could do is a shirt.
No, I'm happy with the shirt. You know, I've been wearing it since you gave it to me. This is my third day in the shirt.
Respect, man. You look good, too, in it.
No, I'm look. You look good, though.
I ain't gonna lie, this motherfucker one of the funniest rappers.
What are you talking about, man?
Hey, yo.
You look good, though.
I'm your owner.
My fault.
Did he leave?
Yeah, I'm sorry, y'all had to.
It was good.
Is that his ass?
It was good.
Is that his ass? Did he answer the call like that? First of all, I don't even see that shit. Wait, did he answer the call like that?
It was good.
Oh my god, he said was good. He literally just said.
I've never made like a big dick line in any of my songs. Like that was my first one. Cause like I'm not on some like, you know, micro shit, you know what I mean? But like I'm also like not crazy, like, you know what I'm saying? But I was so worried that the girls I used to mess with were gonna be like, song's hard, but just know, like, it ain't that big. I'm like, nobody said nothing, so we're in the clear. Maybe they're like, it was like, maybe they think I'm telling the truth. I don't know.
G R.
Fuck, dude. I'm sorry, my bad.
E N. Give me eight. Spirit animal. What's the clownfish? The one where the dude has the baby? That actually might be my spirit animal. What's there's a fish where the man is the one carrying the baby around.
Seahorse. That's a seahorse, bruh.
The seahorse? That's my whole vibe. I wish I was delivering my kid. Don't trust my wife with it. Don't got a wife, but I won't trust her. Wish I was a seahorse and I can deliver. H. Harlow. My last name has a very Caucasian history. It's filled with caucasity. Pretty sure it's like English and Irish. Couldn't be whiter.
Bro. Oh, I saw that. Did you teabag him or something?
Oh, I told you the fight was gonna happen. I told you. Somebody owes me $100. Somebody owes me $100.
There have not been any punches thrown, I don't think.
Let's keep it real. Was there any metal detectors?
No, I'm pretty sure Jack was fucked up for that one. Yeah, I'm pretty sure Jack fucked that one up. That's on him.
Fight right there. I know what he's doing. That's all for look. I did that before. I've done that. He knew somebody was holding him back right there.
Hey, Daddy.
Hey, what you doing, man?
Yo, I heard there was a talent show.
Yeah, man. What you got? What we doing?
I'm looking for new representation right now.
Respect.
So I was wondering.
I knew it. I knew drama and them wasn't doing their job, man. Come on over to Coulda Been.
Well, I heard a lot about Coulda Been, bro.
What you hear, though? On some real shit?
Nothing yet, but I do want to sign.
Respect. Well, we looking for a good upcoming artist. I mean, you got potential. You got the WP.
I got some shit.
Let's do it. Let me hear.
Pontiac, hey, DDG. Yo, DDG went from YouTube to a rap, bro. Like,
I'm ticking like a time bomb, baby.
White,
LOL, keep curling your hair, you little prick. Holy hell. Now, this is the best one. This is the content I was looking for.
You were 14 years old. You thought you might have a chance at a major label record deal, and it just didn't happen. I have to imagine when you're 14, that must have felt like the end of the world.
Oh,
right?
Yeah. No, it was devastating. Yeah.
So how did you overcome that obstacle?
Well, I turned 15, and then I was good.
Do you feel like, this is the one thing we had to ask about. How did you feel about Uzi putting a clown emoji over your face on Instagram?
As soon as I saw it, I got butterflies in my stomach.
Why, just because he was acknowledging you?
Well, I just couldn't believe it. I was just shocked. I didn't think he would acknowledge me.
I'm Puerto Rican, so salute.
You're Puerto Rican?
No.
Oh.
I'm like, wait, what? I was trying to do the math in my head, like carry the one.
Did it seem possible at all?
Yeah, a little bit.
No.
It's the hair, though.
Yeah, okay. It's whatever it is.
Yeah, you know, I remember these. Elementary school, all the pretty girls used to make them and put them on their little fingers and do that thing.
What the fuck? My wig is coming up. All right, I gotta go. Thanks for this.
Love you. Oh, man, I've had a crush on her for months. Yeah, baby. Yeah, baby. I'm over here feeling good now. My tummy feels good.
You have to be buried, cremated, or mummified.
When you get mummified, don't you?
In theory, yeah.
Mummify my ass, because the other two, you don't have a shot. Cremated is, what the fuck are you doing? Like, my mom wants to get cremated. Ugh, why? All
right, man. Appreciate you being here. Appreciate you doing this. You keep forgetting about that Rona, man.
It's okay, you always remember.
The lesson I learned is motherfuckers are insane. So I remember I was at this house party at the Douglas Loop, and it was actually up in this, like, upstairs type area above a restaurant, and I was on the aux cord for the night. And you know, I had the party jumping, like I was playing the right music, I had the vibe going. Like,
okay.
I was, you know, in high school, like I liked
you
to
just
be on the
it
aux.
Out, huh?
I felt like my taste was really up there. But there's this girl.
Wait, what did you say? My bad.
Like I liked to be on the aux. I felt like my taste.
I just tried to like beat him to what he was trying to. It's my bad.
Really up there. But there's this girl that was in my ear the whole night, asking me to play this Crazy Frog song. And I couldn't understand why, but she's pestering me about it. She kept asking me, oh, yo, play this Crazy Frog song. She kept showing me on her phone. I'm like, nah, I ain't playing this song. Like, if I kept
it's
being passive at first. I was
it's
like,
a trash.
I got you.
Wait, fuck. Like, okay, I'm going to shut up.
Like, I was passive at first. I was like, I got you. Because you feel like they might leave you alone. But when I told her, no, I'm not going to play, she like cracked me in my mouth. Like, just cracked me right in my jaw and got carried out of the party. She hit the hell out of me, yo. Punched the shit out of me. It was like a man punched me. I know who Crazy Frog is. I mean, he makes like remixes in a funny voice, I think. But I didn't know that song. I don't know why she wanted to hear it in the middle of this party when Young Thug was playing. I don't know what happened to Crazy Frog. I hope he's still working.
You showed me some wild shit one
yeah,
day, didn't you?
That's what I was going to say. Like being in hip hop, bro, I feel like hip hop is the most, I got to be careful with my words here, but it's like the most homophobic music genre. You know what I'm saying? You definitely push the line.
Whoa, what you trying to say?
No. you say some sus shit, but it's funny as fuck. Oh. But I'm sure people question it because they're like people in hip hop aren't used to people being that loose,
that forward with it.
In a funny way.
In production,
I don't even know what you mean.
I'm saying like I seen a meme one time. I seen a meme you posted, and it was like
he knows what exactly the fuck he talking about. He said, I don't know what you mean. This whole vid is evidence, bro. Ain't no coming back. Whoever made this vid, you fucked for this shit.
And
Drip
barber,
TV,
like,
bro, you fucked.
Like, do you ever want to grab your barber?
Bro, no way he can. You know what I'm saying? Bro.
Dick.
Wait, what?
Something about a barber. Like, do you ever want to grab your barber's dick?
Yeah, you got the wrong man.
Nah, bro. Nah, you're trying to make me feel like an asshole right now, bro.
We got
to
pull it up, man. Yeah, that's not like I suck dick or anything. I'm a chill dude, man. It's fun. I know what you're saying, man.
Hey, fuck it. Never mind.
Wait, man. He said, I don't know?
I know what you're saying, man.
He said, I know or I don't know? Hey,
fuck it.
He
never
said,
mind,
I know.
Man,
on to the next one.
Yeah, on to the next one, man. On to the next.
I had this homegirl, and the house behind her, there was a house with a pool.
Bro, please.
And, you know, the family sort of knew each other. But I found out the owner of the house was blind and deaf. At least that's what she told us, that he was blind and deaf. And so we're like, we low-key had permission to go to this pool. She said we did, but like we started going a lot. Like, I don't know if we had permission the other times, but we used to go there, skinny dip. We would bring different people in there, you know, just be a nice little vibe. But then one night we went, and I remember the window was open, and I looked in the living room, and there was a man standing there, close as hell, looking at the TV. The TV was like right here. And he was standing near the TV. It looked like he was trying to see what was going on out there. Like, we don't know if this dude was really blind or deaf or not. And shout out to the blind, shout out to the deaf, all respect. Like, we didn't know if it was true. So my homeboy went up to the window and started banging on that shit, like, just to see if it was true. Because we had been in this dude's pool. Like, He starts banging the shit out of the window. I'm talking about hit this shit. This dude did not fucking move. So we found out it was true. That this motherfucker's blind and deaf watching TV while we were in his pool. And we just kept pulling up. Shout out to that guy for letting us use the pool though.
Is that it? Huh? No! Oh, I'm watching that. Oh, dude.